And now I give the floor to Her Excellency Retno LP Marsudi, Minister of Foreign Affairs of Indonesia.
Mr. President, we imagine a collective future filled with hope during the Summit of the Future. But this future we all quest for remains under the shadow of nuclear destruction. 13,000 nuclear weapons are retained by a handful of states, including some outside the NPT. Armed controls agreements are abandoned. Nuclear rhetoric becomes more aggressive. Technological advances like AI make nuclear risks even harder to predict and control. Against this grim development, we should ask ourselves, should fear of nuclear weapons be our guarantee of peace? Indonesia's answer will forever be no. Having deposited its instrument of ratification of TPNW, Indonesia reaffirmed its commitment to a nuclear weapon-free world. Indonesia refuses to stand aside while the threat of nuclear war today is higher than any point during the Cold War. We call on a global focus on three actions. First, begin disarmament negotiation in earnest. Inaction is not an option. We must renew our political will and redouble efforts to advance disarmament, rebuild trust, and move toward a nuclear-free world. Second, confront the risk of emerging technologies. We must establish robust regulation and control to prevent increasing threat of nuclear conflicts. Third, ensure a legacy of peace. To nurture a legacy of peace, we must bury our divisions, mistrust, and outdated paradigm, and choose instead unity, cooperation, and commitment to peace. The choices we make today will shape the world for generations to come. Colleagues, fear should not dictate our future. Indonesia remains resolute in our goal for total elimination of nuclear weapons. I thank you very much.
I thank Minister for Foreign Affairs of Indonesia.